Tantor Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents the No Cry Potty Training Solution. Gentle Ways to Help Your Child Say Goodbye to Diapers by Elizabeth Pantley. Narrated by Susan Ericksen. Introduction. Potty training your child shouldn't require an instruction manual the size of a telephone book, nor should it require a visit to your pediatrician. It certainly shouldn't involve a private consultant's assistance. Yet you may be like many other parents who get the idea that this is a complicated, difficult undertaking and can't possibly be done with ease. I have good news. As a parent educator and four-time veteran of the toilet training process, I know that potty training can be simple, pleasant, and, yes, even fun. I've written this guide so that you can sail through the potty training process easily and joyfully with your child. The No Cry Potty Training Quick Guide. The first thing you'll find in this book is a 6-part quick guide to potty training. This is a summary of the high points in this book. It offers everything you need to know to get your child from diapers to underpants. It's simple because potty training should be simple. I'd like to help you eliminate any tense emotions, competitiveness, and analysis before we even get started, as these unnecessarily complicate the process. If you'll follow a few straightforward steps, your child can pleasantly achieve the move out of diapers without stress or tears. Relax. It's simply natural. You've been going to the bathroom for a long, long time, and it's something you do without much thought. Your child has been using a diaper for a long time, and it's something he or she does without much thought. For the first time, your child will learn to listen to his or her body signals and think about getting to the toilet on time. This will be a big change in your child's everyday life, and it's a step toward independence that young children embrace. It's something that every child adjusts to in time, and it's a process that most children enjoy learning. When you approach toilet training with knowledge, respect, patience, and a plan, it can be as normal and uncomplicated as teaching your child how to walk, talk, or use a spoon. This can be a wonderful learning experience for both of you. So here we go. Have fun with potty training! The No Cry Potty Training Solution Quick Guide. The following quick guide will provide you with an overview of the toilet training process. It can serve as an introduction to, or a review of the potty training plan, or as a reminder once you've set up your child's toilet training plan. The quick guide highlights the information contained in the rest of this book, so when you need more details, you can easily refer to the corresponding expanded chapter. Quick Guide 1. Facts about potty training. Potty training can be natural, easy, and peaceful. The first step is to know the facts. The perfect age to begin potty training is different for every child. Your child's best starting age could be anywhere from 18 to 32 months. Pre-potty training preparation can begin when a child is as young as 10 months. You can begin training at any age, but your child's biology, skills, and readiness will determine when he can take over his own toileting. No matter the age that toilet training begins, most children become physically capable of independent toileting between ages 2.5 and 4. It takes 3 to 12 months from the start of training to daytime toilet independence. The more readiness skills that a child possesses, the quicker the process will be. The age that a child masters toileting has absolutely no correlation to future abilities or intelligence. Nighttime dryness is achieved only when a child's physiology supports this. You can't rush it. A parent's readiness to train is just as important as a child's readiness to learn. Most toddlers urinate 4 to 8 times each day, usually about every 2 hours or so. Most toddlers have 1 or 2 bowel movements each day, some have 3, and others skip a day or two in between movements. In general, each child has a regular pattern. More than 80% of children experience setbacks in toilet training. 98% of children are completely daytime independent by age 4. Quick Guide 2. Readiness Quiz. Potty training is easier and happens faster if your child is ready. Take this quiz to find out where your child is on the readiness spectrum. There is an expanded quiz in Chapter 2. 1. I can tell by watching that my child is wetting or filling his diaper. A. Never. B. Sometimes. C. Usually. 2. My toddler's diaper needs to be changed. A. Frequently, every hour or two. B. It varies. C. Every 2 to 3 hours, sometimes less frequently. 3. My child understands the meaning of wet, dry, clean, wash, sit, and go. A. No. B. Some of them. C. Yes. 4. When my child communicates her needs, she, A, says or signs a few basic words and I guess the rest. B, gets her essential points across to me. C, has a good vocabulary and talks to me in sentences. 5. If I give my child a simple direction, such as, put this in the toy box, she, A, doesn't understand or doesn't follow directions. B, will do it if I coach or help her. C, understands me and does it. 6. My child can take his pants off and put them on. A, no. B, with help he can. C, yes. 7. I think that it's the right time to begin potty training my child. A. No. B. I'm undecided. C. Yes. Most answers are A. Wait. Your little one doesn't seem to be ready just yet. Test again in a month or two. Most answers are B. Time for pre-potty training. Get ready. Your child is not quite ready for active training, but you can take steps to prepare your toddler for the future. Gradual introduction of terms and ideas will make potty training easier. Most answers are C. Your toddler is ready to use the potty. It's time to start your potty training adventure. Between two scores. Just like any parenting situation, there are choices to make. If your child is hovering between two categories, your intuition and knowledge of your own child can direct you toward the right plan of action. For more information and the expanded quiz, listen to Chapter 2. Quick Guide 3. Pre-potty training. If your child is near or past his first birthday, you can begin incorporating these ideas into his life. They are simple things that will lay the groundwork for potty training and will make the process much easier when you're ready to begin. During diaper changes, narrate the process to teach your toddler the words and meanings for bathroom-related functions, such as pee-pee and poo-poo. Include descriptive words that you'll use during the process, such as wet, dry, wipe, and wash. If you're comfortable with it, bring your child with you when you use the toilet. Explain what you're doing. Tell him that when he gets bigger, he'll put his pee-pee and poo-poo in the toilet instead of in his diaper. Let him flush the toilet if he wants to. Help your toddler identify what's happening when she wets or fills her diaper. Tell her, "You're going poo-poo in your diaper." Have her watch you dump and flush. Start giving your child simple directions and help him to follow them. For example, ask him to get a toy from another room or to put the spoon in the dishwasher. Encourage your child to do things on her own. Put on her socks, pull up her pants, carry a cup to the sink, or fetch a book. Have a daily sit-and-read time together. Take the quiz again in a month or two to see if you're ready to move on to active potty learning. For more information, listen to Chapter 3. Quick Guide 4. It's potty time! Get ready. Buy a potty chair, a dozen pairs of training pants, four or more elastic waist pants or shorts, and a supply of pull-up diapers or disposables with a feel-the-wetness sensation liner. Get set. Put the potty in the bathroom and tell your child what it's for. Read books about going potty to your child. Let your child practice just sitting on the potty without expecting a deposit. Go. Begin dressing your child in training pants or pull-up diapers. Create a potty routine. Have your child sit on the potty when she first wakes up, after meals, before getting in the car, and before bed. If your child looks like she needs to go, tell, don't ask. Say, "Let's go to the potty." Boys and girls both can learn sitting down. Teach your son to hold his penis down. He can learn to stand when he's tall enough to reach. Your child must relax to go. Read a book, tell a story, sing, or talk about the day. Make hand washing a fun part of the routine. Keep a step stool by the sink and have colorful, child-friendly soap available. Praise her when she goes. Expect accidents and clean them up calmly. Matter-of-factly use diapers or pull-ups for naps and bedtime. Either cover the car seat or use pull-ups or diapers for car trips. Visit new bathrooms frequently when away from home. Be patient. It will take 3 to 12 months for your child to be an independent toileter. Stop. If your child has temper tantrums or sheds tears over potty training, or if you find yourself getting angry, then stop training. Listen to this book, particularly chapters 7 and 8, and try again in a month or two. For more information, listen to chapters 4 and 5. Quick Guide 5. Bedwetting. Young children wet the bed for biological reasons. His kidneys aren't sending a signal to his brain while asleep. His bladder hasn't grown large enough to hold a full night's supply of urine, or he sleeps so deeply he doesn't wake up to go to the bathroom. You can't teach a child to be dry at night until his physiology allows this. It is not under his control. Never wake your child to take him to the bathroom. You'll just disturb his sleep. It's normal. Half of all 3-year-olds and 40% of 4-year-olds wet the bed several times a week. Also, 20 to 25% of 5-year-old children and 10 to 15% of 6-year-olds don't stay dry every night. Bedwetting is hereditary, So if one or both parents were bedwetters, a child has a much greater chance of being one. For a bedwetting toddler or preschooler, the solution is simple. Have your child use the potty before bed, and then have him sleep in a diaper, padded training pants, or disposable absorbent pull-ups. When he has a week of dry mornings, it's time to change to underpants and use a mattress cover until he consistently stays dry all night. According to the National Kidney Foundation, you only need to talk to a doctor about bedwetting if your child is 6 or 7 years of age or older, or if there are other symptoms of a sleep disorder, such as loud, frequent snoring, or symptoms of an infection, such as painful elimination. For more information, listen to Chapter 6. Quick Guide 6. Solving Common Toilet Training Problems. Problem. Your child shows readiness, but won't try. Reasons why it happens. She doesn't understand. The process is not interesting enough. She is going through a negative phase. Solutions. Reevaluate your approach and try something new. Have a few step-by-step lessons and make it fun. Put up a sticker poster or put a bowl of small prizes in the bathroom and award one for each use. Problem. Your child has lots of accidents. Reasons why it happens. He is distracted. He is not noticing his body's warning signs. Solutions. Set a timer to ring every 2 hours. Take him to the potty when it rings. Help him identify his need to go. You're wiggling. Let's go potty. Problem. Your child is constipated. Reasons why it happens. There are problems with her diet. She does not have the patience to sit on the potty. She is feeling pressure about training. She is holding it too long. Solutions. Increase fruit, vegetables, whole grains, and water. Avoid refined sugar, candy, soda, cheese, rice, and junk food. Relax the potty training a bit. Teach her to go as soon as she needs to go. Problem. Your child won't poop on the potty. Reasons why it happens. It feels wrong to him to use the toilet after going in a diaper for so long. He is fearful about the process. He's not yet able to read his body's warning signals. He had a bad experience, such as constipation or a fall off the toilet. Solutions. Reassure him that he's learning and soon he'll have his BMs in the potty. Have him poop in the bathroom, even if it's in his diaper. Clean him in the bathroom. Wipe him on the potty and have him flush. Get a soft padded toilet seat. Don't personalize his stool by talking to it. Line the potty bowl with a diaper or cut the crotch out of a diaper and have him sit and try to go. Read, sing, or tell stories when he is on the potty. Play soft music to help him relax. Problem. Your child won't use the potty at daycare. Reasons why it happens. She relies on parent prompts at home. Different routines are confusing to her. She is not comfortable with the bathroom. She gets too busy playing. Solutions. Practice each morning when you drop her off at daycare. Have routine potty times. Set a plan with your daycare provider. Ask your child what will help. Problem. Your child uses the potty at daycare, but not at home. Reasons why it happens. The daycare schedule or method creates success. Peer pressure motivates him to go. Solutions. Ask the daycare provider for tips. Use the daycare schedule at home. Duplicate the daycare method at home. Create a sticker chart for your child to use. Problem: your child won't go when away from home. Reasons why it happens? She has stage fright. She doesn't understand that she's supposed to. She can't relax when away from home. She is embarrassed. She's not used to a big toilet. She doesn't understand why you cover or clean the seat, or she is scared of the germs. Solutions: bring along a book to read. Visit the potty everywhere you go. Teach her a private signal or word to tell you when she has to go. Tell her that everyone uses toilets everywhere you go. Bring a portable folding toilet seat cover. Don't dwell on germs. Tell her that you cover or clean the seat because it's not your own toilet. Problem: your child was trained but has regressed. Reasons why it happens: a life change is causing stress. He has lost interest. You stopped reminding him. He has a medical problem. Solutions: give extra love and praise. Take him to the potty at routine times. Introduce a sticker chart or potty prizes. Talk to your healthcare provider. Problem: you are getting impatient and angry. Reasons why it happens: things are not progressing according to plan. You have unreasonable expectations. Solutions: read books and articles about potty training. Talk to other experienced parents. Talk to your pediatrician. Stop training for a month or so and regroup. It isn't always easy to determine the reason for a problem, and solutions are not always simple. For more information, listen to chapters 7 and 8. 1. Potty training. What's it all about? At the start of the grand adventure that is teaching a child to use the toilet, many parents wonder how they'll ever accomplish such a complex feat. They watch their toddler with his brand new potty bowl on his head and doubt the sanity that convinced them to purchase it in the first place. The good news is that the vast majority of children are able to master daytime toileting by the age of 3 and a half or so. And for most families, it's a pleasant, even fun experience. Take a moment to think about how you teach your child other new life skills. How do you teach your child to recite the alphabet, draw a picture, tie his shoes, dress himself, or put together a puzzle? Do you spend one full day on intense lessons and then expect your child to pass a test at the end of the day? Would you insist that he show mastery every day thereafter without ever making any mistakes? I doubt it. If you did approach lessons in this way, you'd likely end up frustrated and your child would be in tears. The actual way that we teach children new skills is by doing it gradually over a period of months, celebrating every little victory along the way. This doesn't apply just to toddlers. It's a pattern you'll follow for many years to come with your child, from the first new bicycle, to the first time on skis, to the brand new driver's license, and about a million other new things in between. Think about your part in your child's learning processes. How do you act when teaching your child something new? Are you intense and emotional? Do you insist that he sit still and pay attention? Do you put a crayon in his hand and demand that he work while you sit and worry that he'll never learn to draw a proper picture or print a capital A? Do you think you'll be sitting next to him, taking notes, when he goes to first grade? Do you fret that he'll be wearing Velcro sneakers to high school, or that you'll have to button his tux for him on his wedding day? Of course not. You know that your child will master these skills, and many, many more, during his lifetime, and that teaching him is one of your roles as a parent. Consider your expectations when teaching your child something new. When teaching him to draw a picture, what do you expect will be the first thing he'll put down on paper? A family portrait? No, it's a scribble. And you'll delight in his effort and post his artwork on the refrigerator door. Over time, and with practice, that scribble will take shape, until eventually your child will draw circles and squares, and soon houses, people, and animals. Now think about this next new event in your child's life. Toilet training. You can, and should, approach toilet training the same way that you do any other new skill. Step by step, over time, with joy, kindness, and patience. Keep things in perspective. Not only is there no need to rush the process, but rushing things can lead to disaster. It puts tremendous stress on both you and your child. It makes the whole process a miserable experience instead of the ordinary learning process that it should be. Even more, when stress and pressure enter the picture, it can create.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.